Broadway's closed, no more cabaret shows. Every theater nerd is home thinking this really blows. But the Metzger-Timsons have the answer for you. Could it be up with a star or two?
They've got multiple choice and in that voice.
When the guest stars sing, everyone will rejoice.
So grab a drink,
turn your brain on and think.
It's MT Trivia with the MT.
On Mondays, we wear pink.
Woo! Yeah. We're back. Did you miss us last week?
We're back, babies, and it is a brand new day. Can you feel a brand new day?
Kaka.
Can you?
What? I feel like we have lived a million lifetimes since we saw you last. But here we are. I am Kevin MT.
I'm Chris MT. Welcome to MT Trivia. We are so happy to be here. We're happy to be in a brand new world with a whole brand new president coming our way in 2021.
It's very exciting.
And we are celebrating. I am drinking. Okay, you guys, get into this. I'm drinking pumpkin bourbon, which is like the beer, but you know, their take on bourbon, it's way too sweet. But our special guest tonight told me to add a little apple cider vinegar to my apple cider and pumpkin bourbon cocktail that I made.
So fall.
And I think, verdict's out, but we're nailing it.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Amazing.
It solves all my problems, you guys. I'll send the recipe out.
It is November. We are here. It's a new month, and so we're raising money for a new cause.
That's true.
What are we raising money for this month, Chris?
We are obviously raising money to donate to the two Senate runoffs in Georgia. And you'll see, scrolling across the bottom of the screen, we'll be donating, the network will be donating, we'll be splitting our donations, our tips collective, between the two campaigns. So if you want to tip us tonight, if you're having a good time and you would give us a tip in a bar, throw us a few dollars, you can Venmo us at MT-Trivia, and 100% of those proceeds will be split between the two Senate races in Georgia in January.
Yeah, so take that two-drink minimum that you would spend at 54 Below.
Yes, and all the drinks you would get
Georgia.
Characters after, and just give it all to Georgia.
So at MT-Trivia.
And help us split the Senate.
And the whole network will be collecting over the month, and we'll get that Senate, Senate seats.
Yes, let's get those Senate seats, honey.
So you might have noticed, we're wearing pink. It's not Wednesday.
It's not, but we're embracing, we're living our inner Wednesday today on Monday night. We are so excited for our special guest this evening, who joined the
Broadway cast of Mean Girls. We have Damian and Janis themselves here. The best friends are in the house.
They're gonna play trivia. And they made their debuts in these roles on March 10th, just mere days before Broadway shut down. But they are still Damian and Janis at heart.
They're still Damian and Janis. And when Broadway reopens up, you will catch them as Damian and Janis at the August Wilson. Is that what that theater's called these days?
Yeah. I think so. our first guest, like we said, made her Broadway debut in Mean Girls, covering the role of Janis and Katie. And now she is our full-time Janis. It is the one, the only, Olivia Kaufmann.
And he recently made his Broadway debut as Olaf in Disney's Frozen.
Ooh.
And was immediately snatched up and shipped off to, what's the high school called? In Mean Girls? I don't know. North High?
Yeah.
As Damian.
Right? Yeah. North High.
It's Chad Burris. Let's get to know them a little better.
Woo!
From way is the company way. Executive policy is by me. Okay. I'll never be president, but there's one thing clear. As long as my uncle can stand me, I will still be here.
Hey there, boy, you with the flair and the air of something real. That lurid smile that lingers while it forces me to feel. I believe that I'd have almost died if you'd not come along. Yeah, when you're around, I find I found there is no right or wrong.
All by myself, I wanna be all by myself. Leave me alone. The movie in my mind.
dream they leave behind. A scene I can't erase. And in a strong GI's embrace.
To say, I feel like the coolest kids on the block that we have Damian and Janis with us tonight. Oh, screw the plastics. You two are the ones I want to hang out with.
Exactly.
Shad, I think you were wearing this shirt in one of those videos or like close
very
to
similar.
It.
Very it's, similar.
I love how you both are wearing pink and we were like, nah.
We didn't tell you. It's okay.
Well, I feel like it's to. Understood, but I guess I didn't think about it.
It's been
well,
6 months. Like,
listen, you two are matching, so.
Mm-hmm. That is true.
Welcome to the show. Oh my gosh. You guys, Mean Girls on Broadway. What a hit. What a hit to step into in roles. Were you guys fans of the movie before you did the show?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
That movie's iconic, and these roles are just like, except I realized as I was doing some research, they added last names or changed last names for the show. What's up there? What happened?
I'm not entirely sure exactly what it was, but in the movie, it's Janis Ian, and in the show, it's Janis Sarkisian.
Isn't it? Janis Ian's a real person, right? They found out later that, like, she, they, I wonder
they
if they were, like.
They ruined her life.
Yeah, they were like.
Sarkisian is that Cher's real last name? Am I wrong about that? Sarkisian? Cher? No,
oh, that does sound.
I don't know if that's on purpose or not.
Right,
but.
Throw it in the chat if you know Cher's last name.
Gaze in the chat. Come on.
I don't know.
So you guys had three shows in your respective roles before Broadway shut down.
Yeah.
But how were those three shows? How was the vibe in the August Wilson?
It's all a blur. I feel like we were all working. Someone said it is Cher's last name.
It's Cher's last name. Thank you, Broadway Babies.
But it's all kind of a blur. I think we were all so tired at that time because we were like teching the show and doing the show at night. And I think we were all relieved that we were finally like getting into the show itself and done with rehearsals and had just one version of the show.
Right.
Because they made changes when you guys all took over, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
They added tour changes. So Olivia, you basically, because you joined as a cover beforehand, you were in classic previews, not realizing you were going back into previews, where you were doing one version at night and rehearsing a different version during the day?
Yeah, I was rehearsing the tour version as Janis, and then Erica Henningsen had already left the show, so Becca Peterson and I were doing 4 and 4 as Katie during the week. So during
oh
the week,
God,
I was doing Katie. But it really, I learned a lot about myself and what I can handle. So that was cool. I was like, cool, I'm alive.
You're alive. You survived.
And Chad, were you doing double duty between Frozen and rehearsals for that?
No,
or did you get a break?
I had a day off. But I had a solid day.
Okay.
But yeah, no, I felt bad. Olivia would like walk in for a bit and she would be like a zombie. I'm like, I'm sorry that you're having to do this because I'm just learning one. I think the hardest thing though was like not only were we were playing iconic roles, but replacing
iconic
people in the show too, which also made it a little
more
nerve-wracking.
Two levels of like icons above you. Like
Totally.
Yeah, Chad, is there an added pressure when you're replacing a Tony nominee and, like, the weight that comes with that?
Yeah, I felt like it was a little easier because he is a friend of mine, so he actually knew that I booked it before I did, and he was texting me saying, have you heard? And I'm like, no, I don't think I'm going to do it. And he's like, just hold out. And then he was the first person I called. Sorry, Mom. and he was like, I've known for a couple of days, but I couldn't tell you. They swore me to secrecy. But so that's been special, like, to share it with somebody that was also a friend way before. We toured together in Mormon in, like, 2014. So it's cool to kind of have a relationship with him. But it was scary because he's fierce.
Yes. Oh my God, that's such a great story.
Well, you both are fierce too, and we're thrilled to have you here. So without further ado,
we're gonna play some trivia.
Let's play some trivia, shall we? Right, so okay. If this is your first time joining us for MT Trivia, welcome. We need your help tonight. So our contestants, we have three rounds of trivia. Our contestants are going to be going head to head, but we need you to play along with them because they're gonna need your help and they'll turn to you. So feel free to throw your feel free to throw your answers
in the comments. I got it, honey. We're going to throw your answers in the comments and help them out. But I think without further ado, we should introduce the first round of trivia, which we lovingly call A Simple Choice.
A simple choice. Nothing more. This or that. Either or.
I love when the guests go off screen. It happens every time. They always mouth along with the thing. And Shadow's doing, he's like giving a full Sutton Foster. Like, nobody can see it, but he's like giving it.
Because we all secretly want to be Sutton Foster Lip in Fairly Modern Valley.
But yeah. Everyone does it every week. It's like my little like treat that I get to watch them.
So fortunately for you guys, we do theme our trivia rounds around the two of you. And since you two are in North Shore High School, our theme this week is
musicals set in high schools.
Woo!
All right. So we'll be talking all things high schools. And just so everyone knows at home, if you know the answer, we encourage you to throw it in the chat. Our guests know that they are on a 15-second delay. So we're going to banter. We're going to talk. So don't just know that, it, you know, when your answer doesn't pop up immediately on the screen, that's what's happening. We're just a little ahead of you, but we're going to get there and we're going to throw you on the screen if you get it right or if you have a good response. All right, so here we go. We're gonna start with maybe like the first iconic High School Musical, and that is Bye Bye Birdie. The story of Bye Bye Birdie was inspired by the phenomenon of Elvis Presley and his draft notice into the Army in 1957. The character name Conrad Birdie is a wordplay on the name of this rock and roll rival of Elvis Presley. Is it Conrad Tweety, Conrad Wingman, Conway Twitty, Connie Blue Jay or Conway Robin?
I'm already stressed.
So this is a real person who was like Elvis's like contemporary in the rock and roll scene. I think he also had like a country career. So he was like a crossover artist.
I'm okay. Such a millennial that like you say Conrad Tweety and all I picture is like Twitter. So, like, the blue bird of Twitter.
Yes. They took the name Conrad Birdie and kind of derived it from this this real life person. So, what do we think, folks? What do we think?
I don't want to look at the chat, right? Because that gives it away easy.
I mean, maybe if they're right.
I have it narrowed down to two in my head, but it's just kind of like what I want it to be.
What are the two that you want it to be, Olivia?
A or C.
Because
it sounds fun.
Conrad Tweety and Conway Twitty. We've got a lot of C's in the audience. What are you thinking, Chad?
Well, I don't know. I'm like, what song did this person sing? Like, what is this? I wondered if it's the Robin one.
Conway Robin.
Conway Robin.
That feels like an actual person's name.
It has a nice ring to it, right? Okay, we're going to ask for your final answers now that the audience has weighed in. Chad, final answer?
C.
And final answer?
I was going to say C.
All right.
That sound means you got it right!
I may have guessed. That is the sound.
I truly a guess, and also everyone kept saying C, C.
Well done, our audience, Jimmy Larkin and Stephanie Ott, and everyone in the audience who got that one right. My mother, Karen Timson in the house, everybody got that one. Well done. That's some serious history right there for you. So sorry we started so deep right off the bat.
As we progress further into the future, maybe? I'm sure it'll get easier.
All right, you said millennials. I was like,
I didn't say millennials. All right, here we go. We're going to go to another OG High School Musical, and that is Grease.
The original production of Grease ran for 3,388 performances, making it the longest-running show on Broadway until surpassed by A Chorus Line. Throughout its lengthy run, the show saw many replacements who have gone on to have notable careers in film and television. Which of these actors was not a replacement in the original Broadway production of Grease? Richard Gere, John Travolta, Judy Kaye, Patrick Swayze, or Stockard Channing?
You're the one that... And then we're talking the original version, not the Laura Austin's Max Crumb version, and definitely, yeah, definitely not the Rosie O'Donnell version.
This is all that original production that played 3,300.
I love that 3,380 performances was like the longest running show at the time, and now Family of the Opera's literally paid like 30,000.
And Grease actually technically was playing an off-Broadway theater when it opened, but it was eligible for the Tony Awards for some reason.
Tony rules were different back then.
It won a bunch of Tonys and then transferred to an actual Broadway theater halfway through the run. Fun facts, you guys.
That's crazy. Okay, John Travolta definitely was in it. That was like a whole thing, because I think he didn't play his role. He played like another role, but he didn't play Danny. So let's mark him off the list.
Okay.
I was going to say that the people from like the iconic movie would be too easy in my head to associate with the musical. So I was like, maybe that's trying to throw me off.
Then it's Stockard Channing.
So is it Stockard Channing?
Yeah, that's what I would. I think that that's.
We have a lot of Stockard Channing.
My pal Jimmy says Stockard Channing.
Yes, the audience seems to be going with your thought process here, Olivia, with the movie. Have either of you guys done Grease?
Yes. Yes.
What role did you do? This is my ensemble. I love what we,
ensemble.
But like, which pink lady would you be if you were to do it now? Who's your pink lady?
You're Rizzo.
I'm like a cross between a Rizzo and a Marty, I guess.
Yeah, yeah. I could see you go either way.
Fun fact: the only thing I've auditioned for since living in New York, as far as roles in Grease, were Sandy, and I was really confused by that. I was just like. Okay, like, sure, but...
Well, I feel like they're always trying to, like, shake up the idea of Sandy. I know, you know what I mean?
They're going to go, like, a different way.
You also did play Katie. Like, that... You did understudy Katie.
It was very different. I feel like Grease hasn't aged so well in certain ways.
Yeah, Jimmy Larkin wants to see you as Jan, Chad.
Oh, my God.
I've been in for Roger so many times, and then I get to that final callback where you have to do the hand jive, and everyone's trying to reinvent the hand jive.
Right.
And I'm just like, can you just do the one that was in the movie?
Well, speaking of the hand jive, the very first musical I ever did when I was 6 years old was Grease.
Yes.
And I learned the hand jive. And that Halloween, we went to a Halloween party at the country club, and they had a dance off for the children. And the dance off was the hand jive.
And you won.
And I won. Yeah, and I won a stuffed bat. And you better believe that stuffed bat was the best prize I had ever won up to my 6 years of living at that point. And I was like the pushing kids away on the dance floor. I was like, I know the actual choreography. Crazy. My parents were like, oh God. All right, final answers. Let's go. What do we think? Audience like, is torn between John and Stockard.
I didn't know John Travolta was in a Broadway production of this.
I should have told you.
But then, yeah, I told Chad. So I guess I'll say E, Stockard Channing.
And you're saying, what are you saying, Chad?
The only other one that I'm kind of confused about is Richard Gere, because I'm like, Richard Gere did Grease on Broadway? Like, huh? But I'm going to say Stockard Channing.
Yes!
You guys, Stockard Channing was not in that production of Grease, but Richard Gere did play the role of...
Danny? Kinnicky. Duty!
Sunny, the non-singing role.
Okay.
You know? Non-singing role. And then John Travolta played Duty.
I thought he was a Kinnicky.
He's a Duty. Those
I thought Kinnicky
changes.
Too.
I'm going to fact check you on
Let's
that.
Let's fact check it. You know, sometimes...
I'm pretty sure John Travolta did Kinnicky.
Yeah,
audience?
Let's fact check it. Wikipedia says Duty, but I didn't do a deep dive.
I think he did Kinnicky.
Judy Kaye played Rizzo. And Patrick Swayze was a Danny, obvi.
Didn't know that either.
Dreamy Patrick Swayze. I mean, I didn't know that till today, but I'm just saying, if you had to cast him in a role, I mean, what a dreamboat. Danny Zuko. All right, our next question is about the hit teenage musical, Spring Awakening. This is very lengthy. We're going to get through it, though. Okay, so Duncan Sheik's
Settle in.
Spring Awakening is based on the 1891 German play of the same name by Frank
Say it, honey. Say it. Say it.
What a kind.
I would probably say Vedekind.
Vedekind. Vedekind. Yeah. Okay, great. So, moving on. We're talking about the differences between the musical and the OG play. Which of these is not a difference between the play and the musical? All right, here we go.
So all of these are different except one.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm giving you like contrasting things. Yes. One of these statements is false. That's the easiest way to say
it. There we go.
All right, here we go. In the play, Melchior rapes Wendla. Woo, we're getting dark. In the play, Melchior rapes Wendla in the hayloft at the end of Act One, while in the musical, it's consensual. In the play, Wendla commits suicide when she learns that she is pregnant, while in the musical, she dies from a failed abortion. The play features a mysterious masked man who appears to Melchior in the graveyard, urging him not to commit suicide. And in the musical, that character doesn't exist. And then in the play, the ghost of Moritz tries to convince Melchior to kill himself, while in the musical, the ghost stops him. Or the Latin class scene that introduces Melchior and Moritz in the musical does not exist in the play.
Okay, whoa.
I know, whoa.
I read the play in college, but now I'm like, maybe I'll remember.
They did, the drama department did it when I was in college. And so I was like, it was like, ooh, this is like so interesting.
These are so specific. Like,
yes.
So detailed.
So like we're just looking at the major, like, you know, the major differences, right? So was it rape? Was it consensual? Did he kill himself? Did she kill herself? Or did she die during the abortion?
This is so dark,
you know,
honey.
It's very dark. This play is very dark, you know, like we're dealing with some deep themes. But one of these statements is false. What do we think?
So I'm not understanding this. So all of these are actual differences between the play and the musical, except one of these, the same thing happens in the play and the musical.
Just one of these statements is false.
Yeah, yeah.
I made up one of these answers.
Okay.
The correct answer is the one that I made up.
Like both. Does that make sense? Me and Chad are like.
Yeah.
Like, no, I get it. It's just like
it's niche. This is the hardest niche. One, I promise.
The play is right back there on that bookcase, and I'm like...
Quick, go read the whole thing and report back.
I kind of think that it is... I feel like it's something that was problematic that they changed, maybe. That's why I'm wondering if it's A, because it feels like that would have been really... Like, maybe...
But she say no?
No,
in
I think...
In the musical? At the very end of that? I don't know. I thought the act ends with her being like, no!
I was distracted by Jonathan Groff's butt, to be honest, so I couldn't tell you single line of dialogue.
Yeah,
spoken.
I don't really. That's
also,
all
the people like laying around them, it was a thing.
Yeah,
the thing was swinging.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember her death in the play, but it's not. It's not coming back to me. It's not coming back to me.
We've got a B. We've got an A. We've got a B and a C.
Well, the same person put B and then so C, and it's like,
all right, we're gonna jump for a final answer because I know this is a tough one.
You've stumped everyone.
We don't want to dwell on it, you know.
Yeah, yeah, totally. Okay, I'm gonna go with A.
Okay,
that's where I am too.
Okay.
Oh. Oh no.
You were close.
The correct answer is actually B. In the play and the musical, she dies of the abortion that they give her for the baby.
Good. So, I was really just stuck on A and B.
Yeah.
The masked man threw me. But...
The masked man, a random character in the play, this masked man comes out. He's never been in the play before, and he's just like, don't do it.
That's very Brechtian, I feel like. Yes. It's very
of that era.
Yes.
All right, we're going to move on. We're going to move past Spring Awakening.
Can we move to something happier?
Yes, let's go on to Hairspray. All right, in an early incarnation of the hit Broadway musical Hairspray, Tracy had an 11 o'clock number. It happened after Cooties, before You Can't Stop the Beat.
So we're in the competition. Uh-huh. We're live on air.
We're setting the scene. We're live on air. Cooties ends before You Can Stop the Beat. Tracy came out and sang the song. It was entitled.
Can I just say, as a former nicest kid in town, Cooties is the most fun number to do in the whole show.
Ooh, I never
it's,
got to.
It's easy as pie. You're tired. It's been a long show, and you get to do this little silly.
And Amber's anyway, belting. You love
Amber's
it.
Okay. Belting with. Nobody can see you when you're one of the nicest kids because her wig's blocking you. It's brilliant. Okay.
We love. Okay. So, what was Tracy's 11 o'clock number entitled? Was it? It doesn't get better than. Oh, sorry. It doesn't get better than this. It ain't over till the fat lady sings.
Oh, God.
Everyone deserves to dance. Who needs a crown or step on up?
I hope it's not B, but
I hope it's that one and nothing else because, like, I feel like that's reclaiming the word. Okay.
I love fat. The song title with the question mark. So Tracy I'm loving. Has, who needs
Tracy
a crown,
has but... has body pride in the show.
That's what I'm saying. I feel like B. That's what I'm going with.
What are you going with?
I feel like there's a lot of other issues with that show, so B wouldn't surprise me. And it was cut.
That's a lot of issues.
So we're both going with B?
Sure.
I'm glad they cut that. That would be a hard sell. Could you imagine walking into an audition and being like, at this, hi, my name is Kevin Metzger-Timson, and I'll be singing It Ain't Over to the Fat Lady Sings.
Whoa.
I want to hear the lyrics to that song.
Yeah, I don't know.
I do not.
I did. So a couple of those are actual cut songs from the show. Mm. Step On Up was Motor Mouth Mabel's song
that has to be
in the second
song.
Act instead of before they wrote, the anthem.
I know where I've been.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
And then It Doesn't Get Better Than This was a duet between Wilbur and Tracy.
Oh, that's cute,
right? And then I made up the other ones. Who needs
oh,
a crown?
I love it so much.
And everyone deserves to dance. I thought it was good.
Another good show for the two of you. Olivia, you have a Penny Pingleton in your future,
yes.
I feel.
Oh, I don't know.
I feel like that. And Chad, there's many roles for you in that.
Yeah, I want to be Edna. I'm waiting for my Edna.
Yeah,
you could actually do a journey because I could see you journeying from Mr. Pinky in your younger days to then graduating to Edna. And then I would actually love to see you as a Wilbur in your, once you turn
once
the
you
corner.
Can't wear the heels anymore. You know?
Exactly. Yeah. Take a break.
Graduate.
All right. So this brings us to our Broadway bonus.
All right, our Broadway bonuses are famously not multiple choice.
You just have to know the answer. So, and we're building off of our Hairspray theme. In Hairspray, the line, manipulating the judicial system just to win a contest is un-American, is a direct reference to what current event from the time of its Broadway opening?
What year did this show open on Broadway?
That is the question.
That's a great question.
What was going on in the world when Hairspray opened on Broadway?
Was it the Al Gore was and George W. Bush?
It was the 2000 election.
Very appropriate for this week.
Bush went to the Supreme Court to steal the election. All right.
Okay, he didn't... We're winning right now, so we gotta.
I know, it's true, it's true. But the big controversy of the Bush-Gore election in 2000 led to that iconic line from Hairspray. They were being so topical. It was one of those, wink-wink moments in Broadway. We love.
We love. We love a Hairspray. All right, we got one more question for you in this round.
Here we go.
Round.
We're going to talk about Dear Evan Hansen, Notch. So, a significant portion of the original Broadway cast of Dear Evan Hansen was attached since the very first reading. However, the role of Zoe Murphy was not played by Laura Dreyfus in this initial reading. Instead, Zoe was played by Barrett Wilbur Weed, Anna Kendrick, Krista Rodriguez, Alexandra Socha, or Christy Altomare.
Probably Barrett.
Who was the original Zoe Murphy in the very first reading of Dear Evan Hansen?
Everyone's saying it's Barrett.
I'm sure it's Barrett, yeah.
Was this on purpose?
Not Ariana Grande.
Oh my God. I would love it. We stand in Ariana Grande Zoe.
Everyone is saying it's Barrett. It's definitely Barrett then.
Good for her.
Also, notable cast members of this initial reading included Alex Weiss.
Alex Weiss was as the original Jared.
That's all I got. Good.
Yeah, I can't remember. There was another one. Anyways.
There was more.
I'd love to see her in that.
She would have been. She's very. That's. I could totally see.
That'd be great.
Like,
the perfect.
You write the role of Zoe Murphy. Yeah. You go to Barrett Wilbur.
It's like an angsty team. Angsty. With belts. We love it.
You're going to do your calculations?
Let's do some calculations.
While you're doing that, I'm going to remind our viewers that this month, the Broadway Talk Live Network and MT Trivia, we're raising money for the Georgia Senate runoffs. We are accepting tips via Venmo at MT-Trivia, and 100% of those donations will be pooled with the entire network, and we're going to split them between the two
between candidates. John Ossoff and Rachel Warnock.
Raphael.
Raphael, Rachel. Oh my God.
How's your calculations going over there?
It's going great over here. We are, I think, tied for first place.
Tied.
We love.
That brings us to our second round, which is our audio round, and we love to call it
Name That Diva.
It's hard to be the diva. It's hard to be divine.
All right, so this is very simple. We're going to play you audio clips, and you just have to tell us who's singing.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
And speaking of Dear Evan Hansen, we are sticking with that theme, and tonight's Name That Diva is Name That Waving Through a Window.
Oh my God.
A couple things to note. So because of this delay with the audience, we do want to let them play along. So when you know the answer, just put your hand up and say, I know it. Give us a cue, a visual, and we'll let the song play through so people can write in and give us their best guess. And then we'll go to whoever raised their hand first for the answer before going to the other person.
You can steal. You can work together. And I will give you a hint, and the audience out there, that none of these singers have played the role.
So this is just name the singer singing waving through a window.
Name it the singer. Okay. Here we go. Ready for our first clue? Here we go.
On the outside, all you did will ever be more than all you did was a tap, 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 it will not fly. Waving through a window, oh, I tried to sleep, but nobody could hear, so I wait around.
Oh, we love an option now.
Got options.
Can anybody see? Is anybody waving back at me?
See, it's more fun when they haven't played the role because they get to break all the rules with the
like,
song.
There's no way they would ever be
allowed
to do
in the show because it doesn't make sense, but it's like, it's a concert.
Could it be a cover of the role?
Yeah, a cover. Like, never.
None of these people have been
in
the
show. Did you think it sounds like Colton Ryan?
Yes, because I know Colton. Yeah. So part of it sounded like him, but then the rest
didn't. You're right. It does sound a little like Colton, but it's
none of these are involved with the show. These are all from like concerts. Yeah.
Okay, but they're all Broadway
people.
Oh, Lord. I truly.
Chad, yes?
Wait, can I wait, right?
No, you can go.
No, you wait. Yeah.
Is it Jeremy Jordan?
Oh!
Yes, Chad!
Now I get it. Yes.
Jeremy Jordan just giving you options for days.
Jeremy Jordan, yes. yes, very good. All right, we ready for the next one?
Yes.
Here we go.
On the outside, always looking in. Ever be more than I've always been?
Waving, 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 I just have to say,
people singing, right?
There's some backups, but what I love about this, and we discover this, and you'll hear it on another clip. Here's what I have to say. This song is so hard to sing. It's so hard. And so on some of these, you can tell that they like brought in backup vocalists to like help get them through it. And
I'll
like
get them through so
Olivia, I saw the impulse. I saw the jerk.
You're like, that's when I heard who it.
Who do you think it is?
Is it Mandy Gonzalez?
Mandy Gonzalez from the miscast.
Jimmy Larkin asked for it, and you got it, baby.
Jimmy Larkin, ask and you shall receive.
Mandy Gonzalez, we would never not include Mandy's iconic performance of this song from Miscast Cabaret for MCCU.
It's just the perfect study in like. When you do something in concert, rules do not apply.
No rules. There are no rules.
Just every option.
And you know what she said? You know what she said? She's like, when they were talking about keys, they were like, Mandy, what key do you want to sing this in? And she's like, okay, let's see the highest note I can belt. Women! And she's like, that's it. That's it. Let's do that one. Okay, like, that's okay, the one.
But like, there was some nuance. Like the tap, 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 and she was tap, tap, tapping
she
on those notes.
She tapped it. She
was tap, tap, tapping on those notes.
Also, are these delayed? Because it's like Jeremy Jordan. It's just funny that it came in after Mandy Gonzalez.
Yeah, we might be on. There's delays. Yes.
There's different platforms. Like Jeremy Jordan different delays. If they're on Facebook versus Jeremy Jordan. YouTube. Yeah.
You know, we're working it out. All right, we got another female for you here. We love girl power.
Yes. Here we go. Another lady. Here we go.
On the outside, always looping in. Will I ever be more than what I've always been? Cause I'm tap, tap, tapping on the glass. Waving through a window. I try to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear. While I'm watching people pass. Waving through a window. Ooh. Can anybody see? Is anybody waving back at me? Is anybody waving? Waving, waving. Oh.
Ooh. Yes.
All right. Did Olivia have a hand up first, or was that
Nope, John? That was a yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, who do you think? Yes.
Is that Adrian Warren?
No.
Oh.
It's not, but...
I hear it.
A little.
Here's what I'll say, and I'll help the audience out as well. I have a theory that in order to sing this song as a female, you have to have played Elphaba.
Okay.
We talked about this at length today.
Yes.
So, in other
I've
words,
only
this is
found,
a
I have
Elphaba.
Only found... Elphaba's singing this song.
It's true.
So this is an Elphaba. Anyone out there know? Yeah, it is Adrienne Warren. I will say she is Caucasian. So
it's an iconic Elphaba.
Oh, not the subtle shade.
Oh, subtle shade. I think she's iconic.
Okay. I mean, I think you know.
Too iconic. He's like,
hell no.
Stephanie J. Block's an iconic Alphaba. Idina Menzel's an iconic
like,
Alphaba.
I'm not saying it's like, it's not like a covered standby Alphaba. No. It's like an Alphaba. Not that there's
we've
a,
stumped
all
the
things,
audience. We've stumped all, we can just go list all the audiences.
Yes. All right.
Now I'm just listing in my head. Elphaba, right. I'm like,
that is Rachel Tucker.
Rachel Tucker, everybody.
Yeah.
From London.
That was it. From London. That was niche. I know. It was very niche. That's the hardest one.
Okay, we have one more for you, and I will say, because I don't want to stump you, this is not necessarily known as a performer first and foremost, but is very well known in the Broadway community, and you'll hear two voices,
you'll hear some backup, but we're
looking for the main vocalist, but if you have an idea who the backup is as well, we'll take that as well.
Yeah, I think it's a
this
I think
I've
it's
just
duet.
Really hard today, I'm
this
sorry.
This is a duet.
On the outside, always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been, cause I'm tap, tap, tapping on the glass.
eyes, waving through a window. I try to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear while I watching people pass, waving through a window.
Ooh, I love that.
Can anybody see? Is anybody waving back at me? Is anybody waving, waving, waving? Whoa.
That arrangement's fierce,
right? And that harmony on the top, honey. Ooh.
Truly didn't know who was the main vocalist until he sang by himself, and I was like, okay.
Yeah.
It doesn't. I will say these people are known together. They're known as a duo. So you could just give us the name of the duo. You don't have to pick out who's singing what part.
They're known as a pair.
Yeah.
Also, I feel like I'm back at Pearl, like hearing the song over and over again. We're back at Pearl Studios.
Story of my life.
You're preaching to the choir. Yeah.
Oh my God.
The amount of hours I've spent listening to the song.
Duo. Broadway?
An iconic Broadway duo.
Yes. Anyone out there? Jimmy Larkin wants more hints. They are graduates of the University of Michigan. They are Tony Award winners. Mm-hmm. They are...
But they're not actors.
Oscar award winners. They're Grammy not... award winners.
Oh, it's Pasek and Paul.
Wow,
they sound great.
Honey, they went to the University of Michigan for musical theater. They got those vocal cords in place.
We've heard some of them, honey.
I would love Ben Platt and Noah to, would be very cute
that
if they did that.
That would be a good...
But it is, of course, Ben Pasek and Justin Paul.
The composers of Dear Evan Hansen.
Which is why they were so fierce. Yes.
That was smart.
I made that one hard this week.
One of our harder Name That Divas, but we had to include that one because it's just, you got to pay homage to those two stores. All right, I'm doing some calculations. While I am, Kevin's going to say those names correctly for me. Here we go.
Oh, yeah. Don't forget to, so this month, I was like, what names? Pasek and Paul. This month, we are raising money to help the Georgia Senate runoff. So please feel free to tip us if you take your 2-drink minimum from 54 below, take your ticket, the cost of admission of a rush ticket, Venmo @MT-trivia. We're going to donate 100% of the proceeds. We're going to split them between the Senate runoff between John Ossoff and Raphael
Warnock.
And that's what we're doing this month along with the network. So how are we looking?
We're looking good. I think Chad took the lead on that one, and he was maybe in the lead from the first one, and I didn't get you. So we're gonna say Chad's in the lead, but there's still one more round. So
this one, it's
this is
it's
your
anyone's
chance to
game.
Catch up, Olivia. Okay, and our final round is famously called Sing Out, Louise.
Sing out, Louise.
All right, so it's finally the round that you actually came here to see. Prior to tonight's broadcast, we sent our contestants 3 audio files of various songs, cuts of songs. Don't worry, cuts. We're not, we didn't send them all of Meadowlark.
Well, 5 minutes.
Yeah.
We did not. And we are going to just see if they can finish the song. They're going to get a little bit of vocal, and then when it cuts out, they have to take over and see how well they know these iconic Broadway songs. And like we told them before the show starts, we encourage scatting, we encourage riffing, we encourage
write your own lyrics.
Some Stephen Sondheim action in there. Just see what you got up your sleeve. All right. Like I said, you do have a lifeline if you would
like.
Yes,
we did give them a lifeline. For our 2 contestants, Chad and Olivia, here's the way this works. These are themed. So the first round that we sent you is, you both have recently made your Broadway debuts in principal roles, which is amazing. But you also have a pedigree in that you have understudy experience in your background. And so these are songs from your days as understudies.
Oh.
So what you're going to do is you're going to open file number 1, make sure it's the one label number 1. They don't always go in order when we attach them. Does somebody want to go first? Who's brave?
Who's the brave one?
Step
up. I'll do it, Olivia.
Great.
All right, Chad. So open file number 1.
CB1.
Okay, and just play it?
Just play it and sing for me, my Meadowlark.
I told you to
but I'm not gay. I'm happy just being with you. So what should it matter to me what you do in bed with guys? Nikki, that's wrong. No, it's not. If you were gay, I'd shout, hooray! And here I'd stay, but I wouldn't get in your way. You can sit at the... You can count on me to live every day to tell you it's okay. You were just born that way. And as they say, it's in your DNA, you're gay. If you were gay.
Yay! Yay! The sound's
oh,
already.
Oh, the sound. The sound.
Oh, you get a whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yes! You understudied a lot of roles in Avenue Q at one point, right?
Yeah, that one, Nikki, Trekkie, and what's the older guy's name?
Oh, Brian.
Brian, it was a little strange, but they made it work.
You're like, I'm 21 years old.
Yeah, I was 20, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Amazing.
What a fun show, though. I like, the puppetry and all of that must have been so, like, crazy.
It was nice because I kind of knew some stuff for Olaf whenever I had to
Listen,
do that. It was like,
oh, you gotta be careful. That Jim Henson company is gonna snatch you right off.
No,
you
no
and
more.
John
of that.
Tartaglia. All right, you know that, Olivia. You ready for your understudy
this is
moment?
Your understudy
I'm
challenge.
Nervous because there's very few things it could possibly be, and I'm like, I don't remember most of it.
Again, we encourage new lyrics.
Yeah, okay.
Here we go. Right. Number one.
Okay, number one. It's downloading. I knew it. Don't know the words. Something, something, some something, some something. Something, something. I don't know which verse.
It's the final verse.
God help the outcast. Something, something.
The final line.
The outcast, the children of God.
And for a beautiful final note, we'll give you a...
Yes!
I knew it was going to be something for that because I was like, there's truly only two shows I've understood.
I love it.
Listen, we had to see if you can remember. Oh, this pan is in my face. Has it been there all night?
Oh, I see it. I moved
what
the
happened?
Thing. We have a pan. I moved it over.
I'm just like, what is going
there's
on?
There's a pan. You nailed that. All right, you guys both get a point for that round. Our next round, so Mean Girls on Broadway is obviously based on the movie Mean Girls, and there's a lot of musicals based on movies. And
correct.
So these songs are from those musicals
that are based on movies.
So Chad, you want to open yours and see what awaits you?
Yeah, I'm kind of nervous.
This is number two.
Okay, sorry. There
you should be
go.
Nervous.
Okay. You sweep the feet for me and kiss that dip you better in a gym. Oh no, I'm not ready! His own handkerchief. And da 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 for the something something second for Buddy and the world's greatest dad.
Bring us home!
Wait, here we go!
What is happening?
To be everything
that you expect from me, and I da 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 until I start. Da 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 da. Merry Christmas, everyone! Happy Hanukkah. It's not in my book, honey. Jimmy's like, guess not. It actually was, and then I would forget the words, so I was like, I'm not going to do this anymore.
Jimmy Larkin, I bet this is his book, and the next comment, guess not.
I guess we're going to just give you a...
Yeah, that deserves a hell no.
Mine got a yes, his deserves a yes.
Listen, you know mine. It's all right. It's all right. You know, we're here for the game of it all. Listen, that is an iconic role for you, so you should brush up on those lyrics.
Yeah.
And you can sing it in the original key, honey, so, like, you better
But that's one of those songs, like, once you get started, it's like a train leaving the station. You mess one word up, you're doomed.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
As somebody who understudied the role.
I did the role on tour. Really? And you have to, right before that final, I'm going to try my best beat, there's, like, an instrumental that's, like, cut on the recording where you're just running through the revolving door, like, for fun. And so they're like, we're going to have you run around in, like, three circles before you sing the end of that song.
Oh my god. Yeah, I just hate a wordy song. Just let us belt.
Yeah, right? It's like, I just want to stand there and belt. Exactly. Anyways,
Of course, for the audience, is, if you don't know, is World's Greatest Dad from Elf the Musical, based on the Will Ferrell movie. Olivia, are you so nervous? Did we make you nervous? Are you okay?
I've been nervous this whole time, so. Okay, but wait. So you said we have a lifeline, but how does that work?
The lifeline is
if
your
you open
soundtrack.
Your track and you absolutely panic, you can close it and open the lifeline.
Cool. Yeah.
if you're like, I don't even know how this song goes.
Yeah.
Then, like, let's pull up the sound check.
High likelihood.
Let's
All
try right. your number two, though, and see which movie, with musical based on a movie you have going on.
Okay. Let's see. Downloading. It rings a bell, but I truly have no idea. So this is where I have to do my lifeline.
Do you want to try? That was, of course, Life I Never Led from Sister Act, the musical.
Her face.
No idea.
I've heard so many people sing it as a cut, but I truly do not know it at all.
Well, I guess the lifeline is technically a musical based on a movie, so why don't you open the lifeline?
And space on
me.
Sing.
Piano standing with a wizard, feeling things I've never felt. And though I never show it, I'd be so happy I could melt. And so it will be for the rest of my life. And I want anything else till I die. And in such time.
Yes.
When people say they will scream for Adam Boss's favorite team, the wizard and I.
Yes! Oh, we may have cut it off before then. Yes!
We don't have the ending on there.
Woo! Yes!
All right.
Send that straight to Stephen Schwartz.
We love.
No.
You nailed that. That was fierce. We love a good alphabet. All right. You both get a point for that. Well, Chad, you don't, but Olivia, you'll get a point for that one.
So now we're tied, right?
Now you're tied. All right. So going into our final round. This is it. This is the final round of trivia for you two. You've made it to the finish line. So Damian and Janis joined at the hip, best friends, can finish each other's sentences, but can you finish each other's songs?
Oh.
Chad, here we go.
So wait, what's happening?
You'll see.
So it's my song, I'm assuming.
I have plenty of opinions. Every asshole's got opinions, but it doesn't make them true. What's true is being me, and I'd rather be me. I'd rather be me than be with you. Yeah! So raise them high. Oh, did I?
It's the end.
I'd rather be me. I'd rather be me than be with you. I'd rather be me. I'd rather be me. I'd rather be me than be with you.
Okay, I have a question. You nailed that. I have a question for Olivia.
Yeah.
The vowels at the end there, what's the story?
They make everyone do the, those vowels, right?
She doesn't you do
don't?
It.
I don't do it, but they also just never. I was like, I like it better in my own voice not doing it, so I'm just going to not do it until they tell me to do it, and no one told me to do it.
We had this whole theory where they were like, it sounds more punk rock if you, go modify the vowel.
I think for some people where that note sits in their belt, it's easier to modify the vowel and open it. For me, it's not, and I think because the whole song we're singing that same note over and over and over again, and I think it sounds exciting to like keep it closed and then open it.
I love a pure vowel.
It's your role, Manny.
It's your role. You do what you want. Yes, if you haven't, go check out Olivia's version of I'd Rather Be Me, because she hits the most beautiful pure E vowel at the end. Chad, you nailed that. Woo! All right, Olivia, are you ready for your Mean Girls Damian moment?
Clearly not. Okay.
We expect full acting here, too.
Do it like me.
Where do you belong? Where do you belong? Where do you belong? Where do you belong?
You'll be judged on sight and made to fit. I don't know which part we're on.
It's the beginning.
So, where do you belong? Let's take a walk around the cafeteria, shall we? Okay. Rusty chucks and baby chucks will throw you in a locker if you say hello. The rich donors, the gangsters, whites, they're all smoking the same oregano. Here's the sexually active band geeks. I got two words for you, amateur and ew. And if you like blowing and fingering, it's a crew for you. Back me up, show choir. Say, where do you belong? Where do you belong? I don't remember this part. where do you belong?
All right.
Yeah.
So many verses.
Oh my gosh.
We really just asked Chad to sing I'd Rather Be Me over and over again, and we gave her like the wordy song.
Yeah.
So that was not fair.
That wasn't fair.
That wasn't really fair on our part. I'm sorry about that. But you nailed it.
You did the wordy song too.
Yeah. You all absolutely nailed it. And according to our final calculations,
I think that you're both winners, baby. Wait for the breath. We like to end every empty trivia with Carolee Carmelo belting in a black slip, because is there any other way to end a show? You know?
I would know who that is. I'm like, what?
I love it. You both, thank you so much for being here with us. You are both winners in our hearts. And, you know, we're in quarantine. We're waiting for Broadway to come back. And when it does, we look forward to seeing you on the stage at Mean Girls. But in the meantime, where can people catch you? What do you guys got going on, Chad?
It's not announced yet, but follow me. I'm doing a holiday concert in Arkansas, actually, and it'll be produced virtually, and a special guest Katie Ladner is going to be doing it. So that'll be coming in December. Yeah.
We love it. We love Katie Ladner. And Olivia, you're doing like master classes, and people can like, what's going on with you?
Yes, I am. I'm teaching here and there. I post about it a lot on my Instagram stories. You can follow me at Olivia_Kaufmann for updates on that. I have one coming up on November 21st. But other than that, you can reach out to me on Instagram or follow where else I'm teaching.
That's awesome.
I love it.
Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much for being with us. This is such a blast.
Thanks for having us.
Yes, thanks.
We'll see you back at North Shore High.
Yeah. Yay!
Bye, all guys. Right. Oh. What a fun show with the Mean Girls.
Oh my gosh, I feel so young.
Well, we have a very exciting announcement.
We do.
Because MT
Big
Trivia,
news, don't leave yet.
You can catch us twice next week.
Ooh.
Because we are going to be participating on Sunday evening. This is the 15th, mm-hmm. November 15th, as part of the a virtual premiere, if you will, of a new exciting venture, MT Shorts. And here to tell us a little bit about it is the co-founder, creator. She's an actress extraordinaire. I've been a huge fan of her and her talent for many years.
A gorgeous lady.
Please welcome to your screen, Sarah Ellis.
Oh,
hi, Sarah.
Gosh. Hi.
How are you?
Used to put on makeup. I so appreciate that.
I know. I spend hours a day on Monday in hair and makeup to get ready for this show.
It's true.
So I feel
it
you.
Takes a village, truly. It takes a village.
It really is. So Sunday night, you have a very exciting thing going on. Tell us all about it. MT Shorts. What is MT Shorts?
Well, MT Shorts is an original musical theater production company. We seek to elevate emerging artists as a musical short films as a virtual calling card for their work. So, yeah, we started the company about 2 years ago, and we've been making mini musical films, and it's awesome. And the whole mission is to get emerging artists' work seen on a global scale.
That's
because
incredible.
Sometimes the 50 Girl Below show just doesn't cut it, y'all.
Amen.
I feel that.
Amen.
So what do we have going on Sunday night? What are we, we're going to Rydell High, right?
Yes. So back when the world shut down, Greg and I, my co-founder, Greg Camp, we decided to make a movie musical in quarantine, and we shot it all over Zoom. But we had our friend Drew Fornarola write 4 original new songs for this amazing musical. And it's all shot from the first person perspective of your computer screen. So our star Ryan Redman plays Patty Peters. And a pun absolutely intended, Alan Whitman is Roger Hammerstein. And our friend Kay Brown is playing Audra Patinkin. And it is a love letter to the Broadway industry. Basically, you're following Ryan's cursor throughout the entire screen. And at one point, her high school class reunion, her 10-year class reunion, Rydell High, gets moved to Zoom because of a global pandemic. And she clicks on the screen, and it is 50 of our musical theater, incredible Broadway community, singing and dancing. We have choreography by Kate Bailey from Frozen. I mean, we're doing Zoomography. It's crazy. But we shot this back in May, and we're finally premiering it on November 15th. And this, and it's not only like just the premiere of a movie musical, we're doing it, we're premiering it in this virtual venue called All Together Now. Basically, it's like a theater on your screen. So there are multiple rooms, like interactive breakout rooms that you'll be able to enter. We're transforming the entire thing to the hallways of Rydell High, including history class with yours truly.
With the MT. So if you want to go to history class, you can come play some MT trivia.
Professors Metzger-Timson will be holding class. Better bring your hall pass.
Yes. Exactly. Professors Metzger-Timson. I like that.
I love it.
Yes. So we will be teaching the children on Sunday at 7 o'clock.
Your BFA is getting put to work. Your BFA.
It is. We have special guests that might join us.
Maybe surprise
live demonstrations. Who knows?
What invites.
So Sarah, where can people find this?
How do people come? How do people
show up? Admission is absolutely free. And the entire evening is raising money for the fund for college auditions. So what you got to do is you got to go to mtshorts.com/signup. That's mtshorts.com/signup. And you'll be able to just grab your ticket there. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, magic gods of technology.
Otherwise known as Michael Hull. Thank you.
And we love the fun. We, the Metzger-Timsons, personally love the fund for college auditions.
We make a monthly donation.
We make a monthly donation.
It's so important to us.
It's so important. I feel like when all of this conversation about some of the issues in the past with Broadway and dealing with racism and the inequities and how do we find equality in the Broadway community, we both firmly believe this, that it starts at the college level. We've got to make college training and tuition available and more accessible. And that's what the Fund for College Admissions does. And they provide everything from classes to shoes to they'll pay for
your flights and your audition and applications.
It's amazing. And so we really believe in this cause. And so we're really excited.
And they've sent some incredible young artists to college already in the short few years that they've been
a thing. So,
and one of their scholars is currently in the Broadway's Next on Stage, Broadway World's Next on Stage. She's in the top three for that competition.
Yes.
Wow.
And the kids that are scholars of this program are exceedingly talented. But as we know, in our society, talent and passion are not enough always. And we need to be able to lower the barrier financially for these kids to be able to actually be seen and to succeed so that we have, you know, we're advocating for equity and equality in our entertainment industry.
A BFA should not just be available for the people who come from a privilege.
Yeah.
It should be available for everyone. So, well, we are thrilled to join you again. So you can please come play with us. Please watch the premiere. It's mtshorts.com/signup.
We'll see you. We'll be live in the history classroom from 7 to 7:30. It starts at 7. Is that when the premiere
come
starts?
Come play at 7 o'clock. 7:30 is the the live broadcast where we're going to have performances by Ryan Redman. Alan Wiggins is going to come in. We're playing some fun games throughout
the podcast.
It's going to be really fun. And then 8 o'clock is when High School Musical will be premiered. So,
oh my God, we can't wait. We're so excited to be a part of this. Thank you for having us. And thanks for joining us tonight.
Thank you for having me. This is going to be so freaking fun. And yes, I'm just so glad that we are figuring out how to still create in a digital world.
Yes,
we like love that.
The pulse of musical theater, the pulse of original musicals, the pulse of connecting, all of this is still very much alive.
Yeah.
So this is a really, really great opportunity for you guys to come and hang out with us. So
yeah. Well, thanks for having us. We look forward to it. Again, that is mtshorts.com/signup. And that's this upcoming Sunday, November
15th.
Thanks,
Sarah. All right. We'll see you Sunday.
Thanks for joining us, Sarah.
All right. Thank you all so much for sticking with us tonight. We had a wonderful episode with our Mean Girls friends and Sarah Ellis. And we will see you
twice next week. And be sure to check out all of the Broadway Talk Live offerings this week. You can follow us at BroadwayTalkLive.com. Subscribe. You'll get notifications starting with tomorrow night.
Tomorrow we have on Good Morning Tonight with Michael Hull and Jackie Cox. We have Chaz Wolcott and Sutton Lee Seymour.
Ooh!
One of my favorite drag queens. And that is tomorrow at 7 o'clock on Broadway Talk Live.
And on Thursday at 5:30, the OG show, The Quarantini, with Michael Hull and Dylan Bustamante. This week, they have an extra special, really fun guest that is to be revealed. So check them out. And we will be back here next Monday night at 9 o'clock with more MT Trivia. So thanks for playing. We'll see you next week.
We'll see you then. Bye.